Oxygen is a gas necessary for life and is indicated possibly for all medical and trauma patients. It does have some adverse effects associated with it. High concentrations of oxygen will reduce respiratory drive over time for some COPD patients. And these patients should be carefully monitored, and oxygen should be administered to them in the dose they commonly receive if they're on oxygen all the time, unless they're experiencing respiratory distress, and then oxygen levels should be increased. Precautions. Well, never withhold oxygen from any patient who needs it. It should be given to patients with COPD with caution, but increase the dose as necessary to manage respiratory distress. A simple or partial rebreather face mask must be supplied with at least 6 liters per minute, and non-rebreather face mask must be supplied with at least 12 liters per minute in order to maintain enough flow to provide the patient with oxygen. There are no contraindications to the administration of oxygen, and the common dose ranges for patients include non-rebreather mask of 12 to 15 liters per minute, or for patients receiving oxygen via nasal cannula, 2 to 6 liters per minute for nasal cannula administration. The dose is the same for pediatric patients. Commonly, a nasal cannula delivering 2 to 6 liters per minute of flow rate will administer concentrations of oxygen between 24 and 44%. A partial rebreather mask at 6 to 10 liters per minute would administer a concentration of 35 to 60%. And a non-rebreather mask at 12 to 15 liters per minute will administer a concentration of oxygen of 80 to 100%. Finally, administration of oxygen via bag valve mask will administer patients oxygen at the level of 90 to 100% at the flow rates of 12 to 15 liters per minute.